Hi, everybody. Welcome to Operation Charlie Fox Contributor Cast number 5, I think. Counting is a valuable skill that I possess. Probably 5. Today, I have selected a replay, once again on behalf of our oh-so-generous contributors. Just a couple quick numbers, since this is a thing that I think is fun to do before these. So far, $3,726 in the prize pool. Almost $4,000. Just keep unlocking those stretch goals. Pretty amazing. Pretty amazing stuff. Let me check the top contributors. We've got 194 contributors, 1,313 levels purchased. So almost 200 people have contributed to an almost $4,000 prize pool. That is wonderful. And hopefully the generosity will continue. But without further ado, let's just jump right into this game. As you can see, I've got everything loaded up, and here we go. And I'm going to fade music out carefully. Yeah, there it goes. There it goes. Look how professional I am. I'm the best. Okay. Ready for action. This game is Insane Simon versus Helping Hans. Welcome, everybody. It's going to be Oster versus U.S. forces on Famineville Approach. And Hans is going to be going with a 3-rear echelon start, something I used to like doing way back when in the day. I don't expect it to be that great this patch, but I don't know. Maybe Hans is gonna try and make it work. He immediately runs to take building control here. Building control is one of the biggest strengths of a heavy rear echelon start, because you have a lot of cheap squads that you can send them around and get buildings. And still have a lot of capping power and mobility, being a lot of places at once, but obviously you're not that combat capable. Simon vies for the building right here, but he's not going to make it. Pios force the rear echelons to stop capping and into the building right there, so they're going to take up position in this green cover here and start capturing the territory. So they're taking a little bit of damage here, but they do get the territory under control, at least for now. And Hans is going to move for the fuel point over here on the right side and start getting himself a rifleman. Meanwhile, Simon's gone with an MG42, two grenadiers opening. So he should be able to hold on to his fuel easily enough. He doesn't have quite the same amount of capping power and building taking power that Hans has early on, but he should be able to take the territory that he needs. Spearhead versus Lightning War, Mobile Defense versus Airborne Infantry and Rifle Company. So pretty standard looking loadouts. Mobile defense very popular, I assume, for protection from the M5, which obviously against US forces is not an issue, so I'm not really expecting mobile defense. And then Spearhead and Lightning War both have Tigers, so they're both pretty standard stuff. But no close air support or mechanized assault or anything like that, so these should certainly be viable regardless. Second squad of riflemen out, and third squad of grenadiers on the way. These Pios had to retreat, falling pretty low. No battle phase 1 yet, so he's not getting to tier 2 just yet. And actually, this push by Hans is proving very problematic for Simon to deal with. He's pushed completely off the field, and he will lose control of his fuel point. And these rear echelons are already vet 1. They're actually engaging pretty well. They're helped a little bit by this bulletin, I guess. I mean, not really, but and he'll take control of a building again. With only one north-facing window here, these rear echelons won't do that much damage, but they will delay these grenadiers' advance and also allow these riflemen to close into short range, probably force those grenadiers away. These grenadiers make a push for the center victory point. I'll be able to get that under control. He does not fully reinforce these Pios either. I think I've seen Aimstrong do this before, where he runs around with extremely wounded squads, tries to cap unopposed, but he is going to get caught by these rear echelons. He will fail to take building control here, I think. Yeah, rear echelons get there first, and Pios are just going to take a lot of damage without accomplishing too much here. I don't think he should stick around to try and get this point captured. Maybe. It looks like he's going to get it. Elsewhere on the map, grenadiers have managed to take control of a building. They have riflemen on both sides. We will charge into close range against this squad of superior numbers to force that retreat. Ooh, nicely placed machine gun right there. We'll stop these riflemen on the approach. Hi, Revan 9K. Whoa, and a squad just got wiped. I don't know what happened, but the squad just got wiped. I think it was a rear echelon squad somewhere. Right? Let's check. I can do that. No, a squad of riflemen went down. Ouch. I don't even know how it happened. I missed it. Damn. All right. So that's a really nice pickup for Simon. He's going to follow that up with a sniper. He's going to try and capitalize on that manpower advantage he just secured for himself. As far as kills, it's pretty even. 10 to 11. So yeah, reinforced costs. Uh-oh. That was close. Wow, rear echelon's almost wiped a squad right there. Looks like their retreat path is safe, though. They're going to get to safety. Barely. Sniper's about to hit the field. Hans replaces that lost rifle squad, fielding a fourth one now. Fresh onto the field. I don't think he's got any tech yet. Captain is unlocking here in the base. Meanwhile, Simon also going battle phase one at about the same time. Flamethrower unlocked on this Pio squad. Should be able to chase away rear echelon troops over here. And the MG42 takes control of the central house. Sniper's gonna make its way towards the south. Right now, Han's just spreading out, taking territory with his wounded rear echelon troops, doing a pretty good job of keeping most territory under his control. Good fuel control as well. He's got both fuel points now, taking damage, but really good map control situation for him. Scary retreat on that rifle squad. I think the sniper might get one more shot. Here it comes. We're getting chewed up here. Not quite, just out of range. Maybe out of vision range too. Not sure if these rear echelon troops will be quite so lucky though. Here it comes. For real. There it is. Sniper's very first shot. Oh no. Third shot. I missed two shots, but third shot it takes is a squad wipe. So that's two squad wipes now for Armstrong. Hans has inflicted none in return, so he is definitely falling behind. Kill count's looking relatively even, but Hans has lost two full squads. Of course, the fact that Simon has a sniper means he's got a lot of manpower invested into this unit. If he were to lose that, if Hans were to prioritize killing that sniper, maybe he could turn the manpower situation back in his favor. And reinforcement on rear echelon troops is not that expensive, and his map control situation is also quite good, so. Rear echelon troops pulling away from the munitions point right there. Territory changing hands pretty much unopposed on both sides. These grenadiers will get caught and forced to retreat. Meanwhile, most of Simon's forces making their way across the north. And a steward is in production. Meanwhile, tier 2 is up here in Simon's base. He will be able to start getting out AT guns soon, protect himself. Sniper's up to 6 kills in 7 minutes, despite being fielded very late, so it's actually doing quite well, although a lot of those kills are rear echelon troops, so. Oh! Ooh, that flame burst. Another squad wipe for Simon. Not looking too good for Hans here, but that steward is on the field. Steward has a very good chance of turning the game back around. If it finds the sniper, in fact, it's completely uncountered right now. It could find the sniper and that flamethrower squad. This could be very problematic. That steward is definitely going to be a problem. Grenadier's on their way to try and Faust this. There goes the flamethrower squad. Panzerfaust will damage the steward's engine and pull back to safety away from the Oster base. The threat of the AT gun, which is already in production. The sniper does not retreat, just hanging out in camouflage here towards the middle. Minesweeper providing vision in the south. Slowly getting forced from the building by grenadiers at range. And the map is split pretty much in half. Simon's done a good job of capitalizing on the squad wipes that he's secured. for himself. Takes some territory back in the south with this spare grenadier squad. Now that he's lost his flamethrower and taken a little bit of bleed from the Steward, he's probably going to start losing a little bit of map control again. Hans has gone with infantry company and equipped himself with the LMG that now makes this horrifying, awful noise. Jingle bells. Shuka, 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 shuka. It's like a tambourine or maracas or something.
The capture point is under attack. All right, you dopes, listen up. 75mm gun ready for action. Crew ready. Gather round. I smell orders.
Pack howitzer. Pack howitzer on the field. He's going to try to maybe equalize the manpower situation by picking up some lucky wipes at range. Medical bunker going up here in Simon's base. No battle phase 2 yet. No commander selection yet. And the fuel point will go back into Hans's control, at least briefly. Sniper is going to make its way down there and try to engage as well as it can. Despite the fact the Steward is on the field, the sniper's up to 10 kills in 10 minutes. And that's a late sniper, so that's very good. That's very good. And he's going to start working on this rifle squad here. And he's got protection from the Steward from an AT gun hovering in the general area. Steward is not making a move to engage here. The rifle squad is simply going to pop defensive stance, hold the line for as long as they can. Squad of grenadiers here in the south is forced away in return. So both of them will retreat one squad. Steward's going to look for an opening, I think. Not going to go in too hard, though. Just taking long shots. Ooh, with that grenadier squad. Pack howitzer got a nice hit on the building. Squad inside is forced away, so Simon is not having a whole lot of success in getting a fuel point back. All of his infantry will be pushed back into the base again, and his team weapons are going to have to pull back a little bit and wait for those infantry to get reinforced and sent back onto the battlefield. 115 fuel in the bank for Hans. He might consider teching up, or maybe he's just going to go priest. He might just go priest. He's getting an AT gun to deal with whatever Simon might field, which is going to be late, whatever it is, because he hasn't had much fuel control this game. No battle phase 2 yet, so. Sniper might have him. Might be vulnerable right here. The AT gun does get a shot off on the Steward. May get two shots off on the Steward. It fires, but does not connect. Meanwhile, Pack Howitzer convinces the sniper plus suppresses the machine gun, convinces the sniper to retreat. Minesweeper pushed away in the south. Defensive stance rifleman in the north. Engaging against green cover grenadiers will probably win this, even though those grens are in green cover. They've got LMGs with defensive, and they suppress them in green cover. Wow. But an MG42 moves up on the flank and forces that retreat. Pack howitzer starts taking shots in the area.
The enemy is overrunning one of our capture points.
No commander selection from Simon yet. Gets out a squad of Panzer Grenadiers. He could go mobile defense and maybe get a Puma to help himself versus the Steward, but that would obviously delay any further tech. Other than that, he's got pretty limited options. Maybe G43s, but he doesn't have a whole lot of munitions to spare either. He's just gonna have to find a way to make core units work and get some territory back. LMG riflemen in the south will force away grenadiers attempting lone squad harassment down there, and this harassment will probably also fail in the face of that Steward without a strong anti-Steward mobile counter.
Heavy truck waiting for deployment.
Harassment of the flanks is going to be very dangerous and unlikely to succeed. He briefly captures a munitions point, but immediately loses it. The defensive line he has set up here in the middle might have a little bit more traction. Hans doesn't have a whole lot of forces with which to counterattack right here. MG42 is still in motion, setting up now. Minesweeper might get caught. They will spot the AT gun right there, so that'll inform the Steward's movements. Panzer Grenadiers are going to work on the south. The riflemen that were down here repositioned over towards this area for some reason. And they are pretty low, so Panzer Grenadiers could probably win an engagement against them, even if they did use defensive stance.
Task complete.
AT guns on the field, that's gonna pull back a little bit. Two squads of Panzer Grenadiers. Interesting. Simon has a bit of an opportunity to move up here on Hans's cutoff, and the sniper is going to start work on these riflemen. Late retreat on that squad right there. Late retreat there by Hans. I'm not sure that's going to get away. Sniper's going to take another shot, and there it goes. Drops the LMG too. Packhauser bombarding in this area, trying to maybe get a lucky wipe on that heavily wounded squad. Meanwhile, Hans is trying to chase away some infantry here in the south, but yet another squad wipe against Hans, and I'm not sure Simon has suffered any wipes yet. Oh, except for the flamethrower squad. I forgot about them, so he's lost a little. Not that much, and I don't think the Packhauser's inflicted that much bleed either. It's inflicted two kills, but it's also taken two losses, so far it hasn't done much. Stuart is floundering. There it goes. AT gun gets two shots for free, and the map is turning more and more red. The loss of that rifle squad really hurts, and Panzer Grenadiers seem to be doing a good job of working their way up the map. And the sniper being up to 26 kills in 15 minutes definitely helps. Wow, Hans is bleeding. Sherman in production. There's the Major right there. Ambulance is on the field too, but he can't really set up a forward retreat point right now. Light harassment attempt up here. Looks like it might get shut down. Simon sees it coming. Machine gun set up towards the south, but squad moving up on the flank. Nothing moving to counter just yet. Whoa, what happened down here? A gun crew. A T-gun just got sniped, probably. Wow. Nice hit by the Packhauser right there. AT gun is moving to destroy Hans's AT gun. Hans is going to make a very aggressive maneuver with this Sherman as soon as it hits the field, and I don't think Simon is ready for this. The second AT gun is set up here on the flank. Sherman switches to high explosive rounds and will probably be able to clear this gun. Meanwhile, Stewart is not taking fire. It's blocked by the hedge. Sherman is successful in clearing out this AT gun and will pull back to safety away from the defending pack. Panzer Grenadiers move to recover the AT gun, but I think the Sherman will get clear before it can get another shot off. Sniper moves up to protect against these riflemen during this engagement. Going to be firing very fast at Vet 2. Grenadiers still have to retreat, though. They can't hold the line any longer. Sniper tries to fire from a position in cover, but this AT gun and Sniper are both very exposed. This AT gun as well. Hans's riflemen will be able to advance without anything stopping them. The machine gun needs to get back into the engagement. It's on its way, along with these two squads of infantry. Hans will pop defensive stance. AT gun stops moving. He needs to keep going, but he's too busy microwing the sniper, I think, trying to be sneaky with it. These riflemen chasing down the AT gun right there. Whoa, incendiary round right there. Just wiped another rifle squad. The captain gets pinned down on this push as well, and Simon picks up another squad wipe. This squad of riflemen takes up a position in the building, though, and there goes the sniper, finally. Never managed to make it to Vet 3, but I think it had well over 30 kills. It had who knows how many squad wipes. He definitely got a lot of value out of that sniper. Finally, it will get picked up by Hans. Rifle squad jumping in the building right there. The Sherman is fully repaired and will move to retake some territory here in the north with support of the Stuart. Major going to be doing a little emergency capping since Hans' infantry are looking rather thin, but this looks like he might be picking up a wipe up here with the freshly repaired tank, and there it goes, machine gun cleared.
We got a rifle squad waiting for orders.
We got a full crew ready. All right, you dopes, listen up.
Panzer Grenadiers are going to get building control. Hans may be forced to retreat right here. LMG Grenadiers moving up to support to force that retreat. Major gets everything in the north back under Hans' control. wounded captain moving to take control of territory there in the north. Fresh rifle squad equipped with LMGs here in the base. And still no commander selection from Simon. And his map control situation has definitely turned around, but he's not spending the fuel. He's got 350 fuel in the bank, but he's bleeding manpower so fast that he hasn't spent it at all. Drops an LMG right there. Nasty high explosive round. Panzer Grenadiers trying to move up on the flank, but they get nailed by a pack howitzer shot and get suppressed. Jump in the building. Try and get shots off against the Sherman that way, which is falling dangerously low, but the squad inside might get wiped as well. They get out of there just in time. Fortunately, Hans has nothing nearby with which to follow up and finish the job. If Sherman hadn't gotten one more miracle shot, or if the Steward had been in range to chase, that could have been a very expensive loss. Packhouser still has only two kills, but despite not getting very many kills, it has suppressed quite a few squads, made a difference here and there. Both AT guns still in Simon's control, and he's rotated pretty much all of his forces towards the north, setting up a defensive line up here to try and get these munitions under control. Will allow Hans to harass the south uncontested. Stuart's heading down there. Will perfectly be positioned to head off a light counter-harassment attempt right here. And the Sherman is going to get repaired back here in the U.S. base, along with a couple of reinforcing squads of infantry, and also Hans managed to steal MG42, so that's going to definitely help him a lot. Stealing an MG42 and wiping the snipers had a pretty dramatic impact. The game's kind of turning back around in Hans's favor, although Simon still hasn't spent any of his fuel. If he gets to 13 CPs, he could field a Tiger, and that'll be 230 of it. Still have another 100-some to go. Major recovered an MG42, takes up a position inside this building. Actually be able to do pretty good damage right here. Those Grenadiers are going to have to retreat. Major manages to hold the line with that recovered weapon. Grenadiers are going to start working on the victory point itself. Panzer Grenadiers heading north to push away the rear echelons, walk right into the MG42, so they're going to be forced to retreat right there. And the Sherman is not quite fully repaired, and I think it took another shot while I wasn't watching. Pack Howitzer moves up into a more aggressive position. I wonder if we're going to see a priest from Hans. Got the fuel for it, but he might be scared of the Tiger, rightfully. Simon just hit 13 CPs, so he could call a Tiger, and he's starting to float manpower up a little bit too, so I think that he's cognizant of that option. Still no commander selection, though. Squad is back to full strength. Crowd infantry. Jackson. Hans queues up at Jackson because he wants to preempt whatever heavy tank his opponent is getting, so that's probably the sensible thing to do. Still no tech of any kind from Simon, though. Major leaves his position inside of the building to advance towards the VP, but Grenadiers in the area are going to prevent any advance. Stuart works on some Pioneers here. They'll be forced to retreat. Stuart's going to circle up towards the munitions point, and the Sherman is fully repaired and ready to re-engage. And there it is, finally. Lightning War chosen and a Tiger fielded with 230 fuel left in the bank. Panzer Grenadiers will be forced to retreat by a pack howitzer shot, also by a little bit of damage from the Sherman, which is up to 13 kills, so it's doing quite nicely. The Tiger will move to engage here in the north, finding a rifle squad, getting a little clumped right there. Ooh, that was almost a one shot. Squad falls dangerously low. We'll be able to get away safely. MG42 moved up into a more aggressive location, gets another free, forces another free retreat down there. Similarly, rear echelon troops in the south not going to do a whole lot better. Tiger circles around to engage against the rifleman. Oh no! I don't know if Hans was watching that. Looks like that could be a wipe if the shot connects. Not quite. Infantry squad will get away narrowly. Tiger exposing its rear armor right there. The Jackson will get a free shot off. Tiger's gonna have to pull back for some Light repairs. Overall engagement's trending in Simon's favor, though. A lot of retreats forced for Hans. He's going to be bleeding a lot of manpower. But the armor game, right now, I would think favors Hans. He's got a Jackson and a Sherman and a Stuart all on the field. He has a very mobile force to help him vie for map control. And he's got this AT gun as well. Stuka close air support. Oh, wow. Just got called in on that Sherman. Reversed out of it immediately. Almost didn't get clear. Probably shouldn't leave anything in the strike zone, although that's hard not to do. Maybe I'll get lucky and the Sherman top mount gun will shoot down the plane. Should probably maybe back up his ambulance a little bit. I don't know. I don't even know what that was aimed at, but okay. That second pass didn't really hit anything. AT gun activates armor-piercing rounds to try and convince that Tiger to back off a little bit. No shots connect. Still got a pretty decent amount of health to work with. The Stuart up here is trying to work on some Grenadiers. Takes engine damage from a Panzerfaust and will have to back off slightly. Defensive stance rifleman in the south. Try and get munitions back with major support with the LMG-42. Look like they should win this engagement. They're going down pretty fast. So munitions will fall back into Hans' control here in the south. Tiger moves to engage here in the north. Takes a big hit from the Jackson. I think attack ground right there through the hedge for the Tiger. Connects. Two shots in a row connect. That Jackson's in a lot of danger and needs to pull back. No! There it goes. Panzerschreck volley connects. Pack howitzer shot goes plink. He was not expecting that Panzerschreck squad to move up on the flank right there. And down goes the Jackson. Oh, thank you, Leon. I like it too. Captain gets a shot off. Armor-piercing round bounces right there. Tiger came dangerously close to going down. I think if that armor-piercing shell had penetrated, that could have been a dead Tiger, maybe. Or it would have been very close. Sherman moves up. Ooh, this could be a huge opportunity right here. It's not chasing, though. It doesn't want to go too deep into these AT guns. Probably makes sense not to overextend, but that was a very dangerous situation for those Panzer Grenadiers, briefly. Wow, nice positioning on the AT guns right there. That one up there in the north was so sneaky, I didn't even see that one. And the Sherman goes down. With the Jackson down and the Sherman down, Hans is now in a very, very dangerous situation. He's got to repair that Stuart, but even after doing that, he's got to deal with the fact that his opponent has a Tiger on the field. He doesn't have a whole lot of tools to do that, except for this AT gun. And probably another Jackson soon, but without a Sherman to help himself deal with his opponent's infantry, I'm not sure how he's going to keep control of his game. Oh no. Also, this just happened. So, that doesn't help. When was this game played? Yesterday. This was played today.
Crew ready. God damn it! Crew ready! Get us out of here!
Stay close, and you might live through this.
Okay, kid.
Hans off to a rough start this game. Looked like he might be able to turn things back around.
Crowds are taking one of our points.
Turn things back around, but the loss of all of his tanks, including the theft of his Stuart, is going to make it extremely difficult to recover this game, if not completely impossible. Once this Tiger is fully repaired, may not be much of anything that Hans can do, and in fact, he's going to go with a Sherman right now, which will leave him almost totally defenseless against this Tiger. He's just going to be relying on his AT gun and Captain, and maybe armor-piercing rounds, and maybe some miracle shots off from the pack howitzer. He's got a lot of very soft counters to the Tiger. The loss of his Jackson definitely hurts, though. Captain finds an opportunity against the Stuart here. Gets a little bit of damage. That's going to start backing off. Sherman leaves armor-piercing rounds on, but is not going to overcommit to killing that Stuart. Pack howitzer almost wipes another Grenadier squad right there. That's going to be forced to retreat. It's up to 9 kills, so it's actually finally starting to kind of pay for itself a little bit. Ooh. That is a very deep rifle squad. That tiger's gonna get at least a couple more shots off. I don't think it's gonna get away.
Just got a report of an infantry unit being wiped out.
Han's gonna start making some pretty bold maneuvers with his Sherman right here. I wonder if it's gonna work. He's trying to pick up a wipe on that Grenadier squad. He just switched to high explosive rounds. In this instance, he probably shouldn't have, since there was only one squad member left, and by doing that, he gave it time to reinforce. He could have gotten a really lucky hit and gotten the squad wipe right there if he had not switched round types, but... Nice attempt regardless. Sherman will be pulling back to safety. Captain's gonna retreat right there. And Major is gonna start working on the North Victory Point, but the game is definitely falling out of Han's control. He's lost victory points. His opponent's now 100 VPs in the lead, taking control of the entire map. Han's slowly starting to get boxed back into his base. He's getting another AT gun here because he has no choice. This is the only counter he has to the Tiger, not to mention the Stuart, and he also needs to worry about that. And he probably needs to start picking up some miracle wipes on his opponent's infantry with either pack howitzer or Sherman high explosive rounds. This Sherman's already up to 18 kills, so it's definitely, it's performing. I don't think it's going to be enough, though. Captain makes a play for the center VP, but he's going to be doing it under Tiger and Stuart fire. A T-gun shot connects from way in the back. Panzer Grenadiers might have an opening against the Sherman right here. Can't quite get in range, though. Sherman's going to leave armor-piercing rounds equipped in case it gets another opportunity against the Stuart or the rear of the Tiger. Time on target artillery forces the AT gun right there to reposition as well, gives his Sherman a little bit of room to breathe. Pulls back for repairs in the south. And the Stuart crew has been reinforced and is just being relegated to capture duty since they don't really have anything better to do now that the Stuart has been stolen. They're going to be forced to retreat by their own light tank. Oh, the irony. Well, whoa, what happened? Oh, the Sherman found the opportunity it was looking for against the Stuart there in the south. Nice pickup. Stuka close air support gets called in here in the... somewhere. South? In the middle. And the Tiger's falling a little bit low, just AT gun fire. I think Hans might want to pull them out of the strike zone, though. Which ends there. His ambulance might get shot at. Nope, goes for the AT gun, which will get cleared. Meanwhile, Pack Howitzer is up to 13 kills. Ooh, and it just wiped that squad, and that was a lucky shot. That's the second squad wipe I've seen that Pack Howitzer pick up. That's starting to get a little bit expensive there for Simon, who, by the way, has 500 fuel in the bank. But he would rather just continue supporting his Tiger with infantry, I guess, rather than tech up and get another medium tank or anything like. What was that? Ooh, another AT gun cleared and a huge amount of casualties inflicted by that pass.
A capture point is being overrun.
Uh-oh, target weak point in the south. AT gun's going for one more shot. Doesn't have any support, though. Vetu Sherman's also very mobile. It's got, it navigates the battlefield with ease, whatever that means. Well, it has more acceleration, I know that, so... That helps it get away from those AT guns in the south, which are a little overextended. They don't really have any support at all, but if Hans were to make a play against them, the Tigers... close enough that it could probably get there. Another Sherman on the field. With two Shermans out, it's going to be even more dangerous for Simon to harass. And with only his Tiger, he doesn't have a very mobile counter to this. Obviously, the Sherman cannot extend into a Tiger, especially if supported by AT guns. But if the Tiger's back for repairs, and Simon overextends the squad like he just did, definitely opens up opportunities. Wonder how many Grenadier squads have gone down this game. 3 out of 4, in addition to 2 pyos and the sniper. So at this point there have been a lot of wipes on both sides, but it's still very much a territory game, and Hans is just not succeeding in taking a victory point. If he were to make a coordinated push with all of his forces towards one VP, he'd probably have a decent chance of success, since he has... Oh, he's only got one AT gun. This one got destroyed. With only one AT gun, maybe not. He probably either needs to steal an enemy AT gun or field another AT gun of his own. Sherman's gonna make a really aggressive maneuver right here. This AT gun just got cleared. Another AT gun setup right here does not have a line. MG42 setup right here will also pin down some of the supporting infantry around the Tiger. Meanwhile, the captain will be forced away from the victory point by these infantry. Ooh, that's not a good situation for the Sherman. It's about to take engine damage. And there's Panzer Grenadiers with Panzerstrecks nearby. And the Tiger is on its way to support that. Sherman needs to try to get to safety, hopefully with AT gun coverage. AT gun making its way back towards the base. Although the pack got cleared, there was no opportunity for Hans to recover it. And the Sherman is in extreme danger. Tiger takes another shot, and the Panzerstreck volley finishes the job. Sherman is going to try and trade here. It's Vet 2. They're clumped. It might be able to pick up the squad. Nope, shot does not connect. Tiger shot misses. Sherman gets a rear armor hit. AT gun misses. Tiger's going to pull out of that engagement with Vet 2 and a little bit over half health. But Hans has been doing good harassment of the south, getting the victory point clock back under his control, doing a little bit of territory harassment as well. Pretty lethal on both sides, both players reduced to two or three squads of infantry. Hans has the MG42, but it might get wiped. That's a painful loss. There's Vet 2. Looks like things are turning back into Simon's favor again, who continues to not spend any of his fuel at all. Just using only the Tiger.
All right, you guys, make ready.
Sherman, ready to go. Infantry dealing with the all-round
security. Incoming Panzerstreck!
Vehicle crew takes control of the fuel point there in the south. Rear echelon troops working on the fuel point here in the north. Simon just setting up a defensive line and trying to continue working the VPs, kind of transitioning a lot into pyos for repair power and Panzergrenadiers. He just really likes Panzergrenadiers. He's got 3 squads out on the field. I guess he likes Panzerstrecks. Maybe he feels the Panzergrenadiers are an effective counter to... I don't know. I think that's kind of a lot of elite infantry. He's got the Tiger to break up these defensive stance riflemen, so... it's a lot of manpower to be spending on not Panzer IVs. But, alright. Hey, Vlad. Big hit on those riflemen, they'll be forced away by Stuka close air support called in the center again. Tiger will advance under cover of that plane towards the south, trying to get the victory point down here back under Simon's control. AT gun is set up nicely for this push, gets maybe 2 shots off. 2 shots, both penetrate. Sherman might have an opportunity here, switches to armor piercing rounds. Ooh, shot on the side bounces. That was probably the frontal armor, I think, based on what that looked like. Apparently a gun crew got wiped out. AT gun maybe? Somewhere. Nice harassment here in the north. Captain making his way across the top to get territory under control and keep the clock ticking in Han's favor. He's kind of juggling the VPs and keeping things steady at 78, but he's not really making the clock tick against his opponent, who still has over 250 VPs left. Lane makes another pass here in the base. Captain will be forced to retreat in the north by this Panzer Grenadier squad. They're a vet too, but only have one kill. How does that work? Interesting. They must have been doing a lot of damage, picking up no kills. I have never seen a vet 2 Panzer Grenadier squad with one kill before. That is... Even the Panzer Shrek squad has seven. That's strange. Riflemen find an opportunity against that AT gun right there. Tiger moving up with Pios and an AT gun here towards the middle. Bundle grenade on those riflemen, they're forced to retreat. Sherman making a very aggressive maneuver against the AT gun will clear it. Grenadiers can't quite get in range for the Panzerfaust. This Sherman's up to 29 kills, doing very well, and the Tiger cannot retaliate. Holding steady in the south. And another, ooh, what was that? Main gun destroyed. Oh, Panzer Shrek volley right there. But Sherman gets to vet 3 and 30 kills. And it will also get to safety. But Hans is about to be triple capped, although we'll have 3 Germans? What happened to this one? I don't know. It's dead. Okay. I'll have 2 Shermans. Crew is standing next to a destroyed Sherman. I have no idea what happened to it. Sniper on the field. Interesting choice. Pack howitzer fire manages to clear out the Pios that are threatening this victory point. Sniper forces retreat from this captain. No, my voice didn't change. I got a new microphone a while ago, Vlad.
The enemy is overrunning one of our capture points.
Stand ready.
Sniper making an attempt for the middle with Tiger support, but it needs to be careful. Ducks into a crater over here. Panzer Shrek volley plus AT gun fire. Will pop smoke to try and block AT gun shots, but the Tiger has no problem forcing those riflemen from the capture circle. AT gunfire on the Tiger does light damage, but it will advance under AT gunfire, try to maybe force away. Ooh, hoo, hoo. Sniper picked up by the Sherman right there. That sniper did not pay off at all, and Simon's forces are starting to look very thin, but he's got 750 fuel in the bank that he still has not spent for some reason. Panzer Grenadiers win their engagement against riflemen in the north and are going to start the clock ticking against Hans again. He's got less than 50 points remaining. Shows no signs of being able to muscle that Tiger off the field. Plink, plink, both of those AT guns fail to penetrate. Armor-piercing round goes through. Vehicle crew, oh, just committed suicide. That's not good. There they go. Walked right into those Panzer Grenadiers. Miss squad stands a good chance of clearing out these AT guns. They have no choice but to pull back to safety. Han spending a lot of manpower on bleed here in his base. He might lose that Vet 2 gun. There it goes. That's a shame. Close air support on a Vet 3 Sherman doesn't quite connect. Does only very light damage right there. The Tiger moves up to destroy that AT gun. A lot of destroyed guns here for Hans. Late retreat on those Panzer Grenadiers, but I think they might get away. Yes, they will. Tiger tries to punish those riflemen for sticking around too long, but they're going to get to safety as well. AT gun gets a shot off on the rear of the Tiger. Captain takes heavy damage on his approach. Gun gets cleared, and Hans is reduced to basically nothing but the pack howitzer, one squad of infantry, and his Super Sherman. 33 kills on this thing. As great as it's been, I don't think it's going to be able to turn the game around solo. This Sherman looks like it's about to go down. Ooh, stupid close air support just unloaded a full volley on the Vet 3 Sherman, and it's destroyed by the Tiger right there. With only 15 points remaining, that's probably the final nail in the coffin. There will be no hope of Hans recovering this game. So apparently, spending fuel was not necessary. Never went beyond Battle Phase 1. Oh, he teched to Battle Phase 2, but he never built the tech structure. Fielded one Tiger and then just made infantry for the entire rest of the game. There you have it. GG, well played, being exchanged, and that's the game. Axis wins. Alright, that was Operation Charlie Fox Contributor Cast number 5. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. And more to come in the days leading up to the qualifiers. Remember, everybody, the qualifiers start in a little over a week, I think. Something like that, so. And of course, everybody should be excited for the release of the Brits on September 2nd or 3rd or soon, so. Lots of exciting things happening. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.